Last year, when I reviewed HP Notebook 15, a budget laptop sporting Intel's Core i5 processor, I came out impressed with its performance, its battery life, its build quality, and its port selection. But there was one major flaw which prevented me from giving this laptop a thumbs up. HP has now come back with a refreshed version of this laptop in the year 2021. And in today's video, I want to put this 2021 HP Notebook 15 to the Technopanda test. I'm interested in finding out if HP has addressed all the issues that I highlighted in my original review. So guys, without further ado, let's get started. Essentially, the build quality of this laptop remains identical to last year's model. The price also remains unchanged. At the time of making this video, the latest model of HP Notebook 15 was selling for around $575. So that's similar to what I saw last year. Please check the links in the video description below for the most up-to-date pricing information on this laptop. Now, the chassis, the keyboard, the trackpad, the hinge, the speakers, the webcam, the RAM, SSD configuration, you know, the port selection, including Wi-Fi 6 and Bluetooth 5 connectivity, all these things on the 2021 model of HP Notebook 5, it remains unchanged from the last year's model. I have already covered all these features in my previous detailed review of HP Notebook 15. Please check out that video if you are interested in any of these features. Now, I don't want to waste your time by repeating myself. So what I'm going to do is I will put a link to my earlier review of this laptop in the video description below. So in today's video, I want to focus on the improvements that HP is bringing to the 2021 model. Basically, there are three main upgrades that I see. First is a brand new CPU. Second upgrade is a completely overhauled integrated graphics chipset. And finally, they have a brand new LCD display panel. So let's start with the CPU. HP Notebook 15 is now powered by the Intel's 11th generation Intel Core i5 processor. This is from the Tiger Lake family CPUs. So this is a brand new CPU architecture and it is supposed to compete with AMD's latest Ryzen mobile processors. Here is a chart showing the key differences between this year's Intel processor versus last year's model. So Intel Core i5 1135G7, it brings the new Tiger Lake microarchitecture and it's built on Intel's refined 10 nanometer process technology. So Intel marketing team is calling this 10 nanometer super thin, and they claim that this process technology, it is bringing the same transistor density as TSMC's 7 nanometer process technology. Let's take a look at the CPU cores. So the turbo frequency, the max frequency that these cores can run has gone up from 3.6 to 4.2 gigahertz. You're also getting 8 meg of cache, up from 6 meg from last year's model. So these changes should boost both the single and the multi-core performance of this laptop. Intel has also bumped the PCI Express revision from 3.0 to 4.0. Now, PCIe, it's a high-speed serial expansion bus standard for attaching hardware devices to a computer. So the newer 4.0 version, it is supposed to bring faster data transfer speeds. So on paper, guys, these CPU spec bumps, they look really impressive. But how do they translate into real-world performance? So let's take a look at the CPU passmark benchmark. The latest 11th generation Intel Core i5 processor has completely smoked last year's model and it scores a whopping 23% performance lead. So I think HP has really picked the best CPU in this low thermal envelope. So whether you're planning to do casuals, you know, internet surfing or running productivity apps like Microsoft Office, or if you plan to do software development, or if you're just watching, you know, YouTube videos, this laptop should chug along nicely. By the way, this improved CPU performance also comes with increased battery life. While last year's model was already delivering over 8 hours of battery life, HP has now managed to bump it up to closer to 9 hours, and they have done it without actually increasing the size of the battery. So I think that's pretty impressive. Now, this is nowhere near what Apple is delivering with the MacBook Air with the M1 silicon. That laptop routinely clocks 12 hours of battery life. So, you know, guys, what I'm thinking is I want to review the MacBook Air with Apple's M1 silicon, and I plan to get that laptop and review it down the road, I guess in a month or two. So please subscribe to Technopanda if you don't want to miss out that video. It's going to be a banger because I am a hardcore PC guy. I have never used an Apple laptop. So I want to do a brutal review of MacBook Air and see if all the hype that we are hearing, if it's true, if this laptop is really as good as what Apple is claiming, or if it's just a bunch of hot air. Okay, now let's talk about the GPU. So HP Notebook 15 is using an integrated Intel Iris Xe graphics. This is a brand new graphics architecture from Intel, and it finally brings Intel at parity with AMD and NVIDIA integrated graphics. Now, compared to last year's Intel UHD graphics, which I think were mediocre at best, Intel Xe graphics brings many advancements. Intel has not only bumped the base and the turbo clock frequency, it has also dramatically expanded the number of execution units and shaders in this new GPU architecture. All these improvements bring a significant boost in graphics performance. In iGPU FP32 performance benchmark, Intel Iris Xe graphics was almost 50% faster than last year's Intel UHD graphics. So finally, you will be able to play Fortnite at full HD resolution on this laptop at a respectable frame rate. Now, this graphics chip also supports full hardware acceleration of 4K video codecs like H.264, AVC, and VP9. So that means if you connect this laptop to an external 4K monitor, you will be able to play all 4K streaming videos in full 4K glory without any stuttering or dropped frames. But guys, at the end of the day, this is still an integrated GPU. So keep your expectations in check. Don't expect NVIDIA or AMD discrete GPU class performance. If you are planning to do hardcore gaming, I would still recommend that, you know, you are better off buying a gaming laptop. And if you are interested in, you know, budget gaming laptops, I have reviewed plenty of them, and a playlist of all my video reviews you can find in the video description below. And finally, the biggest and the most important upgrade that HP has made in this laptop, it's in the display quality of the screen. Even though last year's model was sporting a full HD display, I found it to be very underwhelming. This was largely because of the TN panel that HP was using, and these TN panels, they create terrible viewing angles. As long as you are directly looking at the laptop, everything looks fine, but a slight head movement, if you move slightly to the left or right, or if you, you know, tilt your head up or down, the screen quality just goes down the drain. Basically what happens is these TN panels, they're not happy with, you know, skewed viewing angle. So if you're looking at a skewed angle, the brightness and the contrast will get diminished. The text will look fuzzy, and the pictures and videos, they are going to look completely washed out and dull. Thankfully, this year HP has replaced these awful TN panels with glorious IPS panels. Now, personally, I'm a big fan of IPS panels because they have much wider viewing angle. So when you are looking at the laptop screen, you don't have to position yourself, you know, in like almost perfect perpendicular gaze. You can move your head and you can, you know, relax. You can even tilt the screen and you can still read the text, pictures, colors, everything looks still good. So with this update, now you are getting a 15.6 inch full HD IPS screen with anti-glare matte coating. The viewing angles are now much better, and the matte coating drastically cuts down on glares and reflections. Now the maximum screen brightness, it's still 220 nits, same as what you got last year. So that's not going to change, which means it's fine for indoor use. But if you guys are planning to use this laptop outdoors in bright sunlight, forget about it. It's not going to work. And unfortunately, most budget laptop screens, you know, in this price range, they all have this problem. So I honestly cannot ding HP for this. A 400 or 500 nit brightness screen, you know, of the size of 15.6 inch, that's going to cost a lot. So you see those screens in Dell XPS 13 or Microsoft Surface laptop, but then those laptops are like thousands of dollars. So overall, I think HP has mitigated most of the problems I had with last year's model, especially the display quality. And with this upgrade, HP Notebook 15, in my opinion, it has become one of the worthy challengers to the reigning champion of budget laptops. And that's my favorite, Acer Aspire 5. So overall, guys, I'm happy with this year's refresh of HP Notebook 15. It is a big refresh. It's not like a minor bump. And this is because now you are getting Intel's latest 11th generation CPU. And these CPUs are delivering the best in class performance and the best in class battery life. You're also getting a very powerful integrated GPU. You have a nice 1080p full HD IPS screen, so that's great. Now the keyboard, the trackpad, the ports, those were all fine. I didn't have any issue with those in my review from last year's model. So if you want to learn more about those features, please watch that video. It's linked in the video description below. But I still have one problem with this laptop, and that's the lack of user upgradable RAM. Now, most folks will probably be happy with the 8GB RAM that comes with this laptop, but power users, and I know there are many of you power users who like watching my videos, and if you guys want to max out the RAM in this laptop, then you are out of luck because the RAM is not user upgradable. So for you guys, I would still recommend, you know, picking an Acer Aspire 5 laptop because it gives you direct access to the DIMM slots. So I have put links to both this new HP Notebook 15 with 11th generation Intel CPU, and various models of Acer Aspire 5, which I like. They all are linked in the video description below. So that's it for today, guys. What do you think of HP Notebook 15? What do you think of Intel Tiger Lake CPU with the Iris Xe graphics? Please let me know in the comment section below. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda for more videos like this. Also check out TechnoPandaReviews.com, where I have consolidated all the laptop reviews that I have done in the last 1 year. So again, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.